Time for a new Zammad release. Version 6.3 comes with great features and important improvements in general. This is a security update that should be installed as soon as possible. I can't wait to show you around. This video is sponsored by Zammad GmbH. Zammad GmbH as a vendor offers many services around Zammad. This doesn't just include support contacts and software as a service, but also professional trainings for admins and agents. This release comes with breaking changes. Let's take a look at those first. With granular knowledge-based permission, you previously could have lower permission in child categories than in their parents. In Zammad 6.3, this faulty behavior has been fixed. From now on, the permission of a child have to be higher or the same to their parent. If you are using granular permission in your knowledge base, you should revisit these and ensure the permissions are set correct. The corresponding APIs for ticket states and ticket priorities no longer allow the admin.object permission to be used. From now on, they require admin.ticket_state and admin_ticket_priority. This is only relevant if you're adjusting your states and priorities via API. Let's talk about minor quality improvements of Zammad. Zammad 6.2 has introduced nested groups. The previously introduced limit of 5 children has been raised to 9. With this, you can escalate even more with deep, cascaded group selections. This next change is more important for Docker-based installations, but still has an impact on all installations. Zammad will no longer write to opt-zammad-var. This change has two implications with unprocessable emails. Zammad will no longer store emails that are bigger than the allowed email size in a file system at all. This was a backward compatibility relict for older instances. From now on, Zammad will always reply to the sender, telling them that the email was too big. If you don't like this approach, either raise the attachment limit in Zammad or make sure your email server doesn't allow bigger emails than Zammad does. Now, actual unprocessable emails that can't be imported due to a technical failure or invalid meta information will be stored by Zammad. Instead of writing these to the file system, Zammad will store these in its database. This also means new rake tasks that you can and have to use. First, you will have to export the affected email or emails from the database. You can do this by executing rake zammad email_parser failed_email export_all. The console output will tell you where Zammad wrote these emails to. With this location, you can now inspect and edit the problematic emails in question. Should you have a spam email in these exported emails, you can use rake zammad email_parser failed_email delete and the pass to your email. You can provide the whole folder to remove all problematic emails from the file system and database at once. If you have repaired faulty emails that you want to import into Zammad, run rake zammad email_parser failed_email import with a path to the EML. This will tell Zammad to try to import all emails from the given folder. If you want to repair emails one by one, simply provide the file name of the EML you repaired. If the export folder in the file system is empty, it will be removed from your file system. All successfully reprocessed emails will also be removed from the database. Keep in mind to add Zammad run if you are using a package installation to the rake commands. Docker users should also keep in mind that all editors may not be available in the container. You may have to access the files outside your container's context for this reason. The wording of Zammad's knowledge base permissions wasn't, as we Germans would say, the yellow from the egg. It has been improved to reflect what those permissions imply better. This change is very minor and only affects the description, not the permission name itself. Now let's talk about something you've been waiting the whole time. New features. The day has come, you can finally edit and add ticket states and priorities within Zammad's web interface. Gone are the days of manual fiddling around on a console. To adjust any of the two, navigate to the object manager within the admin settings. There you can find the tool gear behind priorities and states. In the ticket state overview, Zammad will list all configured states alongside the default states. If you don't want the open state to be the default state for customer replies, you can adjust any other state to be the default follow-up state. This will cause the ticket state to be changed to another state upon customer reply. If you don't like the new state to be the default state for the new tickets, you can also adjust this. In my test, a restart of Zammad was required in order for these settings to fully behave the way expected. Now let's take a look into a state in detail. As name, you can choose anything you want. Consider these states to be named in English and then translated into the language you need them in. This is a better and cleaner way to do it, especially if you plan to have multi-language support at some point. The state type decides on how the state will behave. This mainly affects the state's color rings, but also if you need a pending state that ends in a new state or just reminds you an action is needed. Any state can ignore escalations. If you have service level agreements in place, this may be desired. By default, pending states do ignore the escalations entirely. If you no longer need a state or don't want specific ones, you can also set that state to inactive. Removing states is not supported to ensure data consistency. Now let's take a quick look over at priorities. The management works very similar to the ticket states. You can rename or add new priorities. If you want another priority to be the default upon creating a ticket, you can change that as well. Beside the name, you can configure the priority color. Currently, you can choose from high and low priority. Low priority tickets will be slightly washed out, while high priority tickets will appear red in your overviews. This visual setting only has an impact on Zammad's overviews. You can also set priorities to inactive. Removing is not possible here as well. An important note about priorities and states. You can potentially disable all priorities and states. Zammad tickets requires both, a state and a priority. For this reason, Zammad will show one priority and state if you disable all of them. These configuration options come with a great danger and potentially allow you to break Zammad functions to a non or only partly functional way. Proceed with absolute care. Zammad's translations are managed centrally in WebLate. This affects all instances upon updates and was a great improvement in the past already. The translations and options we are going to talk about just now only impact your local instance. If you want to contribute to Zammad's translations because your language is not well translated yet, please use translations.zammad.org. The on-screen translation shortcut was changed and thus fixed. You can once again translate specific parts of Zammad's web interface directly at the place you see it. What's left is the translations part in Zammad's admin settings. Zammad no longer shows you all existing translations available. Instead, you can search and find to be translated strings by using the new button. You can do this with any language that's available in Zammad. This interface is also the way how you can add translations for options of, for example, selection fields. To enable this functionality, simply go to your custom objects and enable the option Translate Field Contents. After this, you can translate all selection fields in the translation menu as well. Speaking of translations, with Zammad 6.3 it is also possible to translate variables and triggers and schedulers. You can do this by enabling the option localization of executing changes in any relevant trigger or scheduler. You can select the local to be used. This value will default to the locale within the branding options. You can adjust it to any you require in your use case. To have a variable translated, you will have to put it into a T with brackets. This tells Zammad to translate the content to what you have configured. But wait, there's more. You may have noticed the time zone setting just now. That's right, you can also have time values, for example to tell your customer to when a ticket is pending, in a specific time zone. The timestamp depends on the locale that was selected. Zammad will always append the use time zone to reduce confusion to the actual daytime. If that's not good enough because you may require a different date format, you can also use the DT function. It requires three parameters: the daytime variable, your desired time format, and the time zone to use. This approach does not append the time zone to the date time value. Pretty neat, right? Okay, I'm sure you have waited for this part. Not just in terms of when it finally arrives, but also in this video. Sorry to have you kept waiting on the WhatsApp channel in Zammad. Please note the following important remarks on this topic. It is mandatory to use Meta's WhatsApp Cloud API. Using the WhatsApp Business app is not enough. As of recording of this video, the first 1000 service conversations per month are free. Additional conversations will cost money depending on the region you're located in. At least that's how I understood from reading the pricing page. You should check it yourself to be very sure. You will require a Meta Business and Developer account. You will need an unused phone number at hand. Your Zammad instance has to be accessible via the internet from WhatsApp to receive its webhooks. If you are a Software as a Service customer, this is only available in the Plus tier as of now. Now to technical limitations. I'm sorry, I'll keep it short. A service conversation window lasts 24 hours. This means you can communicate with the customer even without further replies of the customer. After 24 hours, the customer has to reply first. Before that, you cannot write further messages. 23 hours after a message has received, Zammad will automatically send a reminder to the customer. This is an optional feature. The communication has to be initiated by your customer. You cannot contact the customer via WhatsApp directly. Currently, the following media types are supported: text messages, documents, images, audio, videos, and stickers. You are limited to one attachment per outgoing message. You may not send an audio file together with text. Each media type has their own individual size limits as shown right now. Okay, enough theory. For the sake of the length of this video, we do expect that you have configured your app and account as required. We will jump into the configuration part on Zammad's end. To add your very own WhatsApp channel, use the Add Account button on the WhatsApp channel page. You will be requested to provide the WhatsApp business account ID, access token and app secret. On the next step, you can configure the WhatsApp number you want to add to Zammad and a greeting message that will immediately be sent to your customer if the customer contacts you. You can also disable the automatic reminder after 23 hours of customer silence and the target group new WhatsApp tickets go to. In the last step, you will receive the webhook URL and verification token for the API configuration page. On this API page, ensure to also select messages as webhook field. If you don't, no messages will be received by Zammad. You can edit, disable or remove existing WhatsApp channels at any time. You will also find the most recent webhooks from WhatsApp in case you need to check on something. Now you can receive customer messages. Oh, what a coincidence! We have our first customer case. All WhatsApp tickets will have the user's display name, their number and the appendix via WhatsApp in the ticket title. Everything else is almost like any other ticket. The main difference, apart to the 4000 character limit, is the big yellow banner on top of the ticket dialog. With this banner you can always keep track when the conversation window will close. If you're still watching at this part, thanks for sticking around with me up to here. I'd like to thank my colleague Tarek especially for having a cross-read on my video script. And, of course, thanks again to Zammad GmbH for sponsoring this video. What's your favorite feature or change? Let me know in the comments, I'd love to hear your opinion. Until next time, take care.